You're the best, Rosie.
You betcha, Mr. J.
You can call it a modern-day Rosie the Robot.
Rosie is awesome but ugly. So the one thing that I think is beautiful is if you've ever seen the movie Wall-E, Eva, that robot.
Futuristic, minimal, and sleek. If 19-year-old entrepreneur Micah Green gets his way, a new housekeeping robot he created will be on the market by 2017. Maidbot is still in prototype stage, and once complete, Green says it will help take the hotel industry by storm.
It's been the same for like over 100 years. Like they've been doing, the biggest innovation in housekeeping has been the electric vacuum, which came out in 1905.
Maidbot will assist hotel housekeeping staff to clean the floors, and it will eventually make beds and help maintain the bathrooms. The team of eight from Ithaca, New York, says the lightweight machine will do more than just save time. It'll save someone's neck, literally.
Robotics in general focuses on dull, dirty, or dangerous tasks. So housekeeping encompasses all of those.
Studies show that maids and housekeepers have one of the highest injury rates in the hotel industry and in the entire private sector. Coming in at around 40%, back injuries are the most commonly reported, followed by pains in the hand and wrist and shoulder.
A lot of injuries aren't reported, and especially among this kind of workforce, because they're part-time workers, sometimes they're contract workers, and they're probably at risk of losing their jobs.
Grant Essler lectures about OSHA guidelines at Rochester Institute of Technology. He says ergonomic injuries are more subject to underreporting simply because they're not as obvious.
Musculoskeletal injuries are difficult to identify as work-related. It could happen, when you're playing softball or picking up your kid at home.
I find this fascinating. But how is this going to be able to clean my floor and make my bed?
So this is the first step in that direction. But this guy is going to focus on the floors. And essentially what we're doing here is we're creating the robotic vacuum where the impeller will be in the center and then we'll have the intake.
Maidbot's omnidirectional wheels roll forward like normal wheels but can slide sideways and won't skid when it turns. David Moraniti is in charge of the technology. This is the transmitter the team is using to test the product.
Now for traditional aircraft, when you use this, the throttle stick you want to hold in a certain position. So if I want to go forward at a certain rate, I can leave it there.
Maidbot will make its rounds to a few hotels this spring, so staff can check it out. More than anything, the startup's boss says he wants his invention to make a real difference in people's lives.
We're not trying to just sell robots, we're trying to sell time. And if you just imagine the time that we could save by creating a product that does it for you, completely autonomously, to me that's amazing.